Welcome back. Mburu Gige is a poultry farmer from Githunguri in Kiambu County. He ventured into poultry farming 6 years ago. Here is his story.
I started with like 200. And of course, I was so much lying with the brokers. You see, with the brokers, they look for the market, as they say they do. And they'll come, they will choose few of your birds. And they'll tell you, we need specific weights. Yet, they know their target. Of course, you know you have hit your target in terms of weights. But they will, I won't say take advantage, but they will take their time. Yet, your chickens are still feeding on so much. Like, the bigger they get, the bigger number of bags that you keep getting. So, of course, they will come, they'll choose, I'll keep rearing, and they'll go. Others will die in the process, you know, and by that time, you are not in this version of making sure that you first of all wear different shoes when you are checking in into where the birds are. So we had those problems. They will come with their gum boots, so which means they will come with some bacteria. And when they leave, the bacteria will be left behind. And there was a time I lost so much of my birds. And after 200, boost their yields.
Over-reliance on white-collar jobs has played a key role in the rate of unemployment in the country and Africa at large. Government and non-governmental organizations and other stakeholders are urging the youth to take up agribusiness as a main source of livelihood. The biggest challenge is that about 80% of all agriculture in the country is rain-fed, yet climate change is here with us. This means that if more youth like George could come up with such simple solutions that will combat some of the challenges affecting farming, then the future, for a fact, seems to be bright.